Alright guys, I already started this contest, but probably it was super easy, so we're gonna do B now. You have n products, the price of ith product is pi, the ith product has ci functions, the jth function and of the ith product is represented f of ij between 1 and m. What is if there is a product that is strictly superior to the other one? There are I and J such that the ith and jth products satisfy all the following conditions. Print yes, otherwise no. Pi is greater than or equal to Pj. J, you have the price of a product is Pi. The price of the ith product is Pi. The ith product has Ci functions. The jth function, Fij represents the jth function of the ith product is the Fij, okay. You want to represent the conditions, okay. Pi is greater than Pj, the jth product has all functions of the ith product. Pi is greater than Pj, or the jth product has one or more functions of the ith product locks. Jth function of the ith product is represented as an integer fij between I1 and m inclusive. What is for? Okay. The first input is okay. Just like this. IJ43 satisfies all the conditions. IJ is equal to 4. Jth product has all functions of the ith one. Jth product of the ith function. What? J product has all functions of the ith product. This is really, really difficult. P of I is greater than equal to P of J. How do I know that? Oh, wait. 1, 2, 3, 4. One, two, three. I don't understand a single thing. What is going on here? Absolutely don't. Hold up. I'm gonna turn this. Turn my camera off. I need to get a pencil and paper.
A single thing. That's...
Okay, let me see. So we have 35,215. 100,000. And it's 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so this is just the size of what the rest of the input is. So this would be 1 and 3. So CI is just the size of this. All right, and then P1 to PN. So we need to find... We need to find a product that's strictly superior to another one. If there are I and J such that the ith and jth product satisfies all the following, print yes, otherwise print no. So we want to find a PI and PJ, there's PI is greater than or equal to PJ, so we need to find a value here where PI is greater than PJ, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is all P's, so these are all P's. So we need a PI, so if PI is 4, 3, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, wait, let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the 35,000. That he's referring to. That's so this is 35,000 and what is PJ? PJ is 3, so 1, 2, 3. So this is 30,000. So we know. We know P4 is greater than P3. The jth product has all functions of the ith product. Oh. So for P of 4, 1, 5 has all the values. What? Oh, P of 3 has all the values of... So P3 has all values of P4. Yeah. And then what's the last part? PI is greater than PJ. Or the jth product has one or more functions that the ith product lacks. The jth product has one or more functions that the ith product lacks. Okay, so pi, so p of 4 is greater than p of 3, right? So that's the one condition. Or, so in our case, $35,000 is greater than $30,000, right? But we also need to know, or the jth product has one or more functions that the ith product lacks. So we need to check, p3 has one or more values that the okay. I think I understand how to do this. Okay. Wow, this is like super different. This one's like, this is just hard to understand. Okay. All right, so we have N and M. Fudge cakes. Let's call it F. Fuck. CNM. Okay. We need to do this. What is M though? I don't think this was ever used. Oh, between 1 and M inclusive. Okay. Okay. This is so ridiculous. Okay, so we have P, C, and then half the loop, and then I gotta push. Let's just call it each. So we're gonna do each dot push back. We're gonna push P, and then we're gonna push C, and for C values, we're gonna push. Fuck. Do we even care if? Of C1. I don't think we care about the C values. That's just a number. That's just a length. So we don't actually care about this. Oh, man. Okay, I don't know. I don't fucking know. Do I have a K here? I do have a K, okay. C and K, push back. F dot push back. Each. Okay, so we need to loop through every ith and jth value, so, why is this so difficult? Okay, oh fuck, okay. Why is this ridiculous? plus 1, j is less than n, j plus plus. So we're going through these, we're going through this array. At the zeroth column. So if f at I at the zeroth column is greater than or equal to f at j at the zeroth column, so only in this case. Okay, then we also need to check if I is not equal to j. What else we need to check? J-th product has all the functions of the I-th product. I don't think it matters if we sort these by not. So, if all product, I don't know, some function we're going to use, we need to check one more. And we need to check if f of I at 0 is greater than f of j, 0. Said this, or the j power is 1 for. One or more functions. Another function here. Then we're going to see out yes. And then we're going to return. Otherwise, we're going to see out now. This one, we take the ith and the jth. We need to take f, I, j, and f, and then we need to check if the loops from f at 1 down and make sure they have all the values of, wait, what was it? The jth has all the values of the ith product. Okay, so this is not hard. All products. This is just a pain to the right. Understand right. Oh, fuck. I lost it all. Okay, so we're gonna loop from okay. No, okay. Why is it so difficult? The jth product has to have all the functions of the ith product. Jth product? So if I loop from this to that, okay, I could sort from one to the end, so I could sort. No, the ith product has to have all the value. The jth product has all functions of the ith product. Oh, yeah. So the, so 1, 3, 5 must have 1 and 5. So I could just loop through all of I. Jth function needs to have all of the ith values. Okay, okay, my brain's hurting. Okay, we could just create a set of all the... Oh yeah, so this is all I values. So we could just add a... Oh fuck. D is equal to 0, D is less than F of I. That size d plus plus. So we need to add all values dot insert f of I of D, I think. But we want to start from 1. So this, the jth must have all the values of I. So the jth must have Oh, wait. We can use a map here. Store this, right? And then... Oh, I'm trying to think, what am I supposed to do? All J values? What the hell am I supposed to do here? Oh, it's so annoying. Okay, so now we have all the I values and all the J values, and then we need to check if the J product has all of the I values. So we're going to go through all the I values and check if J at all the I values, F of all J values at all I values is greater than or equal. To all I values. Yeah, so if I go through all I values. I need to check if the all J values at X dot first, right, is greater than or equal to all J values at all I values at X dot first. So if it is, then continue. Otherwise, return false. And here, return true. Yeah, I think this would work. Although, we're kind of building this every time though. One or more functions. Oh, that's just exactly the same thing as what we wrote above. But we have to build this again. We're kind of building this every time. So that's a problem. But for now, I don't think it matters. What the fuck? Okay, the jth product is one or more function that I product lacks. J's product is one of our functions that I've product list. Oh. So. Okay, I think this would work, but I don't know whether or not it's efficient. I don't know. Oh, I'm gonna print the index. Fuck. Stop. Stop. What is the error? Oh. I should return cout ij also. So this should be. This should give me 3.2 actually. Because I'm using zero indexing. Just add one also. Come on. 3.2, yeah, that's right. Should give me no. One, two, what? Was it 1, 2? So P of 1. Okay, that's right. What is the next one? P2 has all values. No, this is not. It should not have all values of P1. So something's not right with this one. Oh. No, we don't have a value of 1. This should have given you false. Hold up. This should give you false. Wait, what is I and J? What did I say my answer was? Wait, hold up. And 2, so 0. That is true. P2 has all values of P1, yeah. They're greater than or equal to, but the last check was... Now it should work. I swear, this TLE is, I don't know. Yeah, no. Let's sanity check the first one. Three, two, yeah, that's right. I don't know what this is. Okay. Alright, now we just don't need to print this out, and we can just submit it. I don't know why this took me so long to figure it out. It took me so long to understand this. Wrong answer. Oh my gosh. One wrong answer. What could that be? Oh my gosh. Could that be? Oh, what could this be? You could add all both of them to an array and then sort them both and then check if they're the same. If they're not the same, return false. We could do that also. Hell yeah, we got a seed. Alright, that was... That was hard as fuck. Alright. Oh my god. Those strings. Alright, we have to try to at least solve three right now. So B was hard. B was hard to understand. We need to try C and D. Let me see the standings. What is my score? 300, but what's standings right now? Pretty low right now because I didn't do it fast enough. Yeah. I also joined in late. 5,000. What is that? This guy's cheating. This guy, Michi, is going to increase. I don't know. Alright. I don't know what... Was the third problem hard? They're end sticks with silver balls onto them. Each ball has English letter written on it. Where's reversal? Ith stick is the number of balls stuck onto the ith stick is S of I is a sequence of the letters on the ball starting from one end of the stick. Two sticks are considered the same when the sequence letters on the ball starting from one end of the stick is equal to sequence starting from the other end of the stick. So for integers I and j, the jth stick is considered the same if and only if s of I equals to s of j or its reversal. So what are we trying to find? The length of the string... Wait, the number of balls stuck onto the ith stick is the length of the string. And S of I is a sequence of letters on the ball starting from one end of the stick. Two sticks are considered the same when the sequence of letters on the ball starting from one end of the stick is equal to sequence of letters starting from the other stick. So integers I and J between 1 and inclusive, the ith and J sticks are considered the same if and only if S of I is equal to S of J or its reversal. For the number of different sticks among end sticks. So... Okay, so we have... Okay. I might just go straight into the input. D, E, A, B, C. Okay. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. A, B, C is equal to the reversal of S4, so S2. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. S2 is equal to the reversal S4, so this is equal to that. So the second and the fourth stick are considered the same. S2 equals the S6 ABC, so the second and sixth sticks are considered the same. First, second, and sixth. Third is same as fifth. So, yeah, I don't know. Second and sixth is easy to count because they're just the same, right? Third and fifth are also just the same. So that would just be two. Second and fourth. So one, two, and oh, okay, this is so easy. Okay. Loop through, use a map, add one. Count the ones that are already like repeating. So if you're already repeating, use string LL if you're already repeating. So if it's already greater than zero, then increment one to the counter. Right? So just keep going down. Keep inserting it, otherwise we're gonna insert it. Okay, so okay, so this is not that hard. And then all we need to do is find the ones that are repeating, like equal to the reversal, right? And that's not hard because all we have to do is just. Reverse it and check if the map is greater than one. Yeah, so this is not hard. The second problem was already really hard. Call it P or something. P dot push back. Fucking hell. Okay. Okay, so this is gonna be ca occur. All right, so we're gonna loop through this. Oh, fuck. Okay, so we have to go back. For every string, we'll build an occurrence. So if occur at x dot first, right? So if this occurrence is already greater than zero, we're gonna do a count plus plus. Why can't I do this? Oh. Count plus plus. Otherwise, if it's we're gonna do occur at x plus plus. Right? So if it's already greater than zero, so if we reach to something that greater than zero, then we're gonna add one to it. Yeah. And then that would just be the number of different ones. Now all we have to do is loop through it again and then reverse it and should do the exact same thing. So we just have to do loop through it again. So we loop through this one. This time we're gonna reverse it. So we're gonna do. Oh my gosh. CBA. And then if there's a CBA that's greater than it. Yeah, so this time we're gonna reverse it. So. I think I could do that. String rev, x inverse rev. Oh, count plus plus, rev plus plus. This time, we need to create an curve. Why is it so hard? Rev occur. Okay, now we just see our count. Okay, so I think this should still work also. Though I'm not 100% sure. There should be 3. Now, if it gets greater than 3 because we overcounted, we could just divide by 2. See if that does anything. Oh, fuck, it's 4. God damn it. Okay, why is it 4? Why are you 4? Okay, so we add A, we add ABC, we add DE, we add CBA. Okay, we see a DE again. So we add plus 1. We see a ABC again, so we plus 1. So we have 2. And that's it. Rev counter. Okay, so A, we reverse A. We get A. Does it exert greater than? Nope. So we add A to it. Okay. ABC, reverse ABC, CBA. Nope. Answer CBA. So we have A, CBA. DE, we're going to reverse it, we get ED. So. Add ED. Oh. It's counting. Oh my God, this is so ridiculous. Okay, we don't want to store reverse. We want to. See, A, B, C. E, D. Ah! So we want to go back to this occurrence right here, and we rather just reverse it and then check if this is also greater than 0. So we need, all we could do an OR, occur at rev is also greater than 0. So that's the case, this should give me 3. Oh my God. Yeah, it should give me 3. So now here's the problem is there might be a case where this fails. I just don't know if this is true or not. Two wrong answers. How many wrong answers do we have? I only got 1 AC. Everything else is wrong. Ugh!
The number of balls stuck onto the IJ is the length of it.
Okay, I think I understand. We don't want to do this while it's doing it. We want to use the same occurrence, so we want to loop through the string again, do this, but then this time we reverse it, and we don't use this, so we don't increment the count. We only do this, so we do string x, god damn it, I just completely deleted it. String v is equal to x. Reverse v dot begin. Oh, this is so painful. Why is it so hard? Oh no, I'm a Gina. Why is it 6? Just divided by 2 in the end. Reverse. What? What? Okay, reverse cannot equal to itself. Okay, so we got 3. Why? Wait. No. ABC. Oh, we already seen ABC. Oh, fuck. Okay. Create a set. This you already seen. Ah, seeing a scene. Like a fucking bullshit. No. So hard. What is it for? We've already seen ABC. Why is it for? Why Why is it 4 though? So we reverse 4. Okay. I've seen A. Why is this 4? Okay, so this one's right. ABC. We already seen ABC. Insert ABC. Oh my God. Okay, so this is 3. I think I'm gonna get another wrong answer though. Oh, what is the wrong answer? Please tell me I got like at least one more right. Okay, I got everything else wrong. We add both the reversal and the thing to the string. So we add both. Aha. It should be 3, so yeah, this is right. Let's see if this works. We're throwing poop at the wall at this point. Throwing poop at the wall. Alright, if we're still getting another wrong answer, then maybe we should actually look up some test cases. This is just throwing poop at the wall. I'm throwing poop at the wall. I'm still wrong, okay. Oh, okay. What is the standing right now? Because I think I'm losing points. But you don't gain points until you actually solve the problem, so it doesn't really... I feel like more people solved the second problem now. Okay, yeah. Still be gray. solve this third one. I believe. What is... Okay. Can I just use... I could... what are the input statements? It's pretty big. Alright, since we already have both of the stuff here, we could brute force. I need the brute force to work. And then we could think about... It's gonna be 6. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay. I don't know if I could do this. Thank you. we could do this. I think you can though, but I don't know. Okay, string x is going to equal to p at I. We're going to do p at I is going to equal to this doohickey. Yeah. Okay. Why are you not working? Oh, it's literally changing all the values here. Yeah, if, do it here. Why is it 4 now? Oh my god, this is ridiculous. Oh my god. What? Oh. Okay, we still need this, but we're going to mark all the values. So we're not going to do this. What we are going to do is we're going to create a set string marked. X Okay, okay, so this is right, but I don't even know if... Okay, so hold up. Let me just make sure the marked is right. I'm literally just throwing poop on the wall. Oh no, stop. What is marked? Hopefully this works. Oh, come on. Unless I'm double counting again. Oh my god. What am I double counting? What exactly am I double counting though? We need to find a brute force solution. Or it's reversal, yeah. Okay. Here's what I'm thinking. If you add 7 and then 8 CBA again, it should still be 3. So if we do... So if we put 7... And then we do all this stuff, and then we add another CBA, it should still be 3. Yeah, okay, so that was that test case. Wait, no. It should be 4. Hold up. Oh man, I should. Can I debug this in time? Time. It should be 4 though. Mark. marked DCBA.
Okay, I think I got another idea. So we're not going to use marked. Oh, wait, we are going to use marked. But instead, we're going to reverse marked. So we're going to do insert reverse. Then if any of these values, then if I go through P and if X is equal to count plus plus. We have 4 minutes left. Oh, go through our reverse. Oh, fuck. I don't think that makes any sense. Oh, Wait. Okay, let's just submit this. What am I doing wrong? I don't get it. All right, I'm curious. How do you do this problem? Oh my gosh. How do you do this problem? How did this guy get the first, second problem wrong? I don't understand. How do you do see? I don't understand. 2
to...
Video, rate, comment, subscribe. I'll check you guys later. Peace.